Assalamualaikum and good afternoon everyone. I'm Muhammad Akmal Hafiz bin Muhammad Arman Said from School of Mechanical Engineering, University Technology Malaysia, going to present on my undergraduate project 1. The title for my undergraduate project 1 is in gas production based on coconut shell for tar reduction process using 50 degrees with a device in fixed bed gasifier. For your information, my supervisor for this project is Dr. Nur Azila binti Osman. Before I proceed to my presentation, let me briefly introduce the outline for my presentation. First of all, I would like to start with the introduction, followed by the literature review, and last, I will explain about the methodology that will be used in order to complete this project. For the introduction, there are 5 subtopics under this chapter. The first is background study. Next is the objective, and followed by the scope of study. Fourth, I will explain on the significance of study, and last, the organization for this undergraduate project 1. Each country which has its own petroleum will be managed to export to be proceed and export to the market. According to BASU, United States of America, Iraq, Saudi Arabia, and other countries from the Middle East are the biggest country with the most production of petroleum in the world. However, some political economic crisis between them had led to the oil crisis that affect the low price of petroleum. Therefore, some researches has been done to provide alternative energy source without fully depending on the petroleum. On 2001 and 2010, Malaysia government has come out with a policy to support on the renewable energy. The policy has encouraged utilization of renewable resources such as biomass, solar, and mini hydro. They also utilize the energy efficiency and prolong the lifespan of the national oil and gas. There are 4 main objectives for this undergraduate project. First, to prepare the feedstock from the coconut shell. Second, to determine the process of gasifier in order to reduce the tar formation. Third, to determine the ability of gasifier cleaning unit in order to trap the tar and particulate formation. Last, to evaluate tar reduction value from gasification process based on the coconut shell using 50 degrees Celsius device in fixed bed gasifier. Next, we will look into the scope for this project. The first one, the feedstock from a coconut shell is prepared using a grinding machine to obtain smaller size of the feedstock. Second, the fixed bed drilling flow reactor is used for the gasification activity. Third, utilizing the coconut shell feedstock performance for the gasifier. Fourth, determine the performance of gasifier cleaning unit. And last is to analyze the tar reduction value after cleanup process by control and fix the swirler angle device at 50 degrees. There are 2 significant of study that are being developed by this project. First, encourage the manufacturer and plantation to provide a proper way in order to dispose and utilize the agriculture waste, especially for the coconut shell. Second, encourage the industry and manufacturer to use the biomass as the alternative fuel to generate energy despite of using oil and gas. This undergraduate project will took approximately 10 weeks to be finished, start from June 2020 until 3rd September 2020. Second chapter for the undergraduate project is about the literature review. In this presentation, I would like to present on the 3 main ideas, which is the gasification process, the agriculture waste, and last is about the type of gasifier. Agriculture waste can be considered as organic matters, which is biomass. Biomass is an attractive choice to substitute the conventional fossil fuels because of its abundant availability, its net zero emission of carbon dioxide, and the most important, it is being renewable. Next, I will explain more about the coconut shell. The reason why I choose the coconut shell is Malaysia is the 4th largest industrial crop behind the oil palm, rubber and rice, with the most of the plantation found in the Sabah and Sarawak. According to a report by the Malaysia Agriculture Research and Development Institute, MARDI, the country is among the top 10 coconut producers in the world, although production fell between 2014 and 2016. Therefore, the coconut shell is good because it has a high calorific value. Second, it's a lower ash content, high volatile matter, which is suitable for a pyrolysis process. And last, it's easy to get and available at a cheap price. There are two types of agricultural waste characteristic determination. First, ultimate analysis, and second, proximate analysis. Ultimate analysis is used to determine the elemental composition of solid biomass fuel such as nitrogen, carbon, oxygen, sulfur, and hydrogen, while the proximate analysis composition of the biomass in terms of gross components such as volatile matter, ash, moisture content, and fixed carbon. Next is about the synthesis gases. Syngas is an abbreviation of a synthesis gas. Syngas is commonly produced by gasification of carbon fuel to a gaseous product such as carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, and hydrogen under a certain heat conditions. Basically, there are four stages of gasification process as shown in the figure below. The first one is drying zone, followed by the pyrolysis zone. Third is the gasification zone, and fourth is the combustion zone. Biomass can be converted to electricity, heat, and fuel via mechanical extraction, biochemical, and thermochemical, such as pyrolysis, combustion, and gasification process. Among all these processes, gasification of biomass is one of the most reliable processes assignable to its high energy efficiency. Gasification is the sole process that converts biomass into synthesis gases as it generates heat and power. There are three types of fixed bed gasifier commonly used, which is updraft, downdraft, and cross-draft fixed bed gasifier. However, the cross-draft fixed bed gasifier will not be discussed in this project because of its complicated of operational process. For the updraft fixed bed gasifier, biomass is introduced from the top and moved downward. The oxidizer is introduced at the bottom and flow upward. Sun drying occur producer gas is extracted to the top. For the downdraft fixed bed gasifier, the biomass is introduced from the top and moved downward. The oxidizer is introduced at the top and flow downward. Next, the producer gas is extracted at the bottom at the grid level. The table shows the advantages and disadvantages for using the updraft and the downdraft fixed bed gasifier. Based on the literature review, we can conclude that the gasification process is the best process to convert biomass into electrical energy. Furthermore, the agriculture waste, such as coconut shell, has the ability to use a feedstock for the gasification and it has a high calorific value. Lastly, we are interested in using the downdraft fixed bed gasifier since our objective is to reduce the tar reduction content, and the downdraft gasifier prove it was the best type of the gasifier in order to fulfill the objective. The third chapter for this undergraduate project is about the methodology. There are four steps which are going to use in this project. The first is preparation of the feedstock. Second, further the combustion. Next, performance analysis. And last, analyze the tar reduction. The first step in feedstock preparation is to identify the gross calorific value. GCV is a calorific value of a substance that is obtained by combusting the substance completely. It is determined by using the bomb calorimeter. It is important to know the gross calorific value because it shows the potential of the agricultural waste to be solid fuel. The second step in preparing the feedstock is to do a proximate analysis. The proximate analysis is used to determine the moisture content and the N constant for the feedstock. The ash content is necessary to measure the amount of non-combustible residue left after a substance is burned. The picture shows the experimental setup for the downdraft fixed bed gasifier which are going to be used for this undergraduate project. There are more details about the fixed bed gasifier swirling flow. There are six main components in the fixed bed gasifier. The first one is the hopper, which is the feedstock will be put. Second is the reactor, which is the combustion will be occur. The third one is the blower band. The fourth part is the cyclone. The fifth is the filter, where we are going to analyze the gas content. And last is the flare point. Here are the preliminary results for the proximate analysis, ultimate analysis, and the calorific value for this undergraduate project based on the previous research. For the theoretical value, it shows that the coconut shell could produce about 20 megajoule per kg, the amount of calorific value. In order to determine the gas quality for the syngas, there are four main types of gases. The first one is the carbon monoxide, second hydrogen, carbon dioxide, and methane. For the carbon dioxide, it should consist of 30 to 60% for the hydrogen, it should consist of 25 to 30% for the carbon dioxide, 5 to 15% and the methane 0 to 5% and others, which is 1%. For the conclusion, we can conclude that the coconut shell is enabled to be used for the feedstock because it contains a high calorific value, which is stable to produce the energy. The second, reduce the ethyl formation using 50 degrees Celsius device in the fixed bed gasifier. And last, we can ensure the ability of the gasifier cleaning unit in order to trap the tar and the particle formation. That's all for me. Thank you.